These days, I absolutely adore watching mainstream game journalists try to cover video games because games, they're not easy enough. Apparently, if a game doesn't have an easy button, oh my god, you gotta throw it in the trash. What's more, even easy mode is too hard, like you're gonna see in this article in front of you. And that tells you a lot. What these folks want, apparently, is a cinematic experience. They want to be able to mash a few buttons, progress forward, and in an hour and a half something be over. Essentially, they want a mini movie. And well, when I'm going through, I get bored playing that way. I want to go through, I want to be challenged to a certain degree, depending on what level of mastery that I want to achieve, but I do want to have fun. Fun is not sitting there and just smashing away on buttons. Done that before, and yeah, most of the games that actually adopt that these days, they failed. Companies that do that fail. So hey there, so today I want to return to that wonderful world of gaming journos, and this is from the Washington Post. Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order is a good game, so why am I so unhappy playing it? I don't know, because you actually had to try. We'll look at this article too, but before we do, if you like this kind of content, you want to help an umbrella out, help us with our interactions. That means subbing to the channel, sharing videos, but also liking, commenting, just any type of interaction. You can just say interaction in the comments, that helps out. Also, if you need a drink because you got to get through this kind of stuff, if you walk out of the room exasperated, you're like, oh my god, I can't stand this, I'll let it play in the background. Definitely helps out. And thank you in advance. So, Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. It makes me so unhappy playing it. Now, what's funny about this is right off the bat, we're going to have to define what exactly is a good game. That way, when they go through and they complain about it, they can still say, this is a good game, and yet, I'm sure that there's a certain company out there that wants a specific connotation with their game. You know, one that probably gives the Washington Post quite a bit of money. But still, you have to have gaming journalists go in and say, where's my easy button at? Where is it? Yeah, easy mode? Not easy enough. So to fully understand quality and your potential enjoyment of Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, you must first decide how you define the term good. If you define the term technically as a label applied to something worthy of merit, then you'll appreciate Fallen Order. Okay, so if I go out and apply it technically, I'm going to have fun with it. It may even wow you at times. If you ultimately define that term as happiness, as Aristotle did, Fallen Order will likely leave you wanting, or more likely hurting. It's going to hurt you. And look at the way that they add to this in just a second here. So the people who will embrace the latter definition and see the game as enjoyable are people who derive pleasure from testing their limits. Okay, so I'll actually want to be challenged. Fun times there. Given how often Fallen Order's mechanics induce mental anguish, oh man, you're going to need therapy afterwards, this game should similarly appear to masochists. That's right. They say that this game, oh man, it's so hard for me to play that, well, it should be right up there with what a masochist would enjoy. Fun times again. The game is far more grind than joyride, more effort than ease, and as a result, takes far more time than the casual gamer would like to reap its full rewards. However, those rewards, primarily a strong Star Wars-worthy story, makes the painstaking struggle worthwhile, if not enjoyable. Now, you have everything you need to know about these folks right here. I mean, that is talking about it's more effort than ease, so you actually have to put time in it. They also use words like casual gamer. I always like that when they add that in. Remember, a certain someone way back when told us a casual gamer is a person that plays Candy Crush. So, Candy Crush players probably won't enjoy this game. Fun times there, huh? Fun times. So Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order is a trying game. Virtually nothing is easy. I like that word there. Even in easy mode here, it can kill you repeatedly if you don't take the time to learn the game's required movement and combat techniques. Even then, you'll likely die multiple times in frustrating ways. So here, they're actually complaining about going into easy mode and having to learn game mechanics. I mean, can you imagine picking up a game and not thinking you need to learn the basics to it? Well, you know, I set this down in easy mode. road. I thought I would just button mash and be able to get away from it, but I actually still had to go in and learn movement and combat techniques. Holy crap. The Respawn team chose to tweak the third-person melee model of previous Star Wars games. It's commendable, given the long drought in Star Wars games. A recycled version of The Force Unleashed probably would have been welcomed by a mass audience. Introducing melee mechanics similar to Shadows Die Twice that encourage a timing-based, defense-first approach to combat was a potentially brilliant decision. However, the precision required in duels or the inconsistency with which the game requires a player's input prevents Fallen Order from reaching its full potential from the perspective of a Star Wars fan who doesn't have much time to invest in mastering extremely challenging fundamentals. Again, right here, from the perspective of a Star Wars fan who doesn't have much time to invest in. So they didn't want to spend a lot of time. What they wanted was an easy review. Again, what they want is a gaming journalist mode. So you can go in, you can get a free comp, you put in no money, so there's no stake involved in that. And then they want an easy ride where they can spit out something and get paid for it. See, that tells you that. Would you really want to spend that much money on something is what they should be asking themselves. With $60 investments, what would your expectations be? That's what a lot of these people, they forget while they're writing their comps. So they don't think about that at all. They don't care about that. So they go on complaining about timing. You know, timing is of the essence, but, and I don't know if that's my problem or the PS4 or Pro, but I think it's not my problem because I kept having those issues. You can see how much they complain about this too. They complain about movement as well, how hard moving is for them, how syncing that up, because again, they don't want to invest a lot of time, and it got anger out of them. The game coaxed anger out of them because they would fall and die. Oh my God. Timing, like I said, they complain about so much within this. And then they even throw in there, you know, Yoda's mantra here, fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering frequently came to their mind, though. Fortunately, falling to your demise doesn't force you back to the last save point, which are infrequent. If I did, I would have quit the game outright. Ultimately, I endured, and I was rewarded by a strong Star Wars story. So, then they finally go in, and they tell you about that. The beauty of the script stems from the story's themes rather than plot points. So, they go through, and they give you this small point telling you, hey, I liked the idea that this had a great story, but I don't want to spend time actually earning those plot points. I actually want to go through, I just want to have this little experience there. Well, if you want to have that, then go to YouTube, watch somebody beat the freaking game, or just watch the story narratives that somebody cut out. Then you won't have to work at all. But then again, if you don't have to work at all, why are you covering the game like this at all? As someone with limited time to play games, the shame of Fallen Order stems from multiple frustrations. Hard to fight, and worse, it's hard to move. Gaming time and issues distracts me from both the story and the beautifully constructed worlds. I was too focused on simply staying alive. My many deaths discouraged me from exploring worlds, all of them beautiful, as did the simple fact that traveling by foot takes forever. So again, I don't want to invest any time. They give you the idea with that. I really wish the game handled travel better. I 100%ed Spider-Man because I love swinging down Fifth Avenue. Could always hop a subway if I was in order. So they should have added subways to this. But thanks to that theme-rich story, the game does have redeeming qualities that serve up enough of a reward to make all the suffering worthwhile. The shame of it is that the combat and mechanics were just a little tighter, a little more forgiving. This would have been one of the better games of the year. As it is, I'll look forward to a sequel with equal amounts of excitement, dread, and hope for improvement. If it was just a little bit easier, you know, if the easy mode was really, 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 really easy, then I would have really liked it. So many game articles sound like this. Like I said, this is not what I want to hear from these folks. But again, It's either this or they complain about the protagonist not being female, something like that. There's always this narrative slant. They always sound the same. And well, that's why these kind of things nobody really listens to unless they're laughing. I mean, I wonder, do these people understand that they've become a punchline? I wonder. Tell me what you think about this. As always, I want to thank you for showing up. Thank you for participating. You make these endeavors possible. These folks, they forget everything, and well, let them indeed. If they can't remember why they're there to cover something, other people will pick that up, and they'll appreciate you showing up too. So anyway, thank you for showing up. Thank you for participating. Want to help out with those interactions? Appreciate that, but appreciate your time in advance.